But I do mean more. I mean that if we had to render Plato's general kind of view with the least changes made necessary by the intervening 2,000 years of human experience and social organization, in aesthetic attainment, in science, and in religion, we should have to set about the construction of a philosophy of organism. In such a philosophy, the actuality of constituting the process of the world are conceived as exemplifying them. 39. 40. Discussions and applications. Ingression or participation of other things which constitute the potentiality of production from any actual assertion. The things which are temporal arise by their participation in the things which are eternal.
Subjectivity of the actual entity in question. Feeling
Discretion 1917-1918. The address. Dopamine interaction of body and mind. Develop the fundamental principles suggested by this word. Crash and storm. 41. Operation. Affecting a transition into subjectivity. They replace it. Neutral stuff. Absurd and realistic philosophers. An actual entity is a process, and is not describable in terms of the morphology of a stuff. This use of the term, feeling, has a close analogy to Alexander's Four use of the term, enjoyment, and has also some kinship with Bergson's use of the term, intuition. A near analogy is Locke's use of the term, idea, including ideas of particular things, cf. His essay, 3, 3, 2, 6, and 7. But the word, feeling, is used in these lectures, is even more reminiscent of Descartes. For example, let it be so. Phil is at least quite certain that it seems to me that I see light, that I hear noise and that I feel heat. That cannot be. False. Properly speaking, it is what is in me called feeling, sentire, and used in this precise sense that is no other thing than thinking. Five, in Cartesian language, the essence of an actual entity consists solely in the fact that it is a prehending thing, i.e., a substance whose whole essence or nature is the prehending point of its aim. Feeling belongs to the positive species 66 of prehension. There are two species of prehension, the positive species and the negative species. An actual entity has a perfectly definite bond with each item in the universe. This determinate bond is its prehension of that item. A negative prehension is the definite exclusion of that item from positive contribution to the subject's own real internal constitution. This doctrine involves the position that a negative prehension expresses a bond. A positive prehension is the definite inclusion of that item into positive contribution to the subject's own real internal constitution. This positive inclusion is called it feeling of that item. Other entities are required to express how any one item is felt. All actual entities in the actual world, relatively to a given actual entity is subject, are necessarily felt by that subject, though in general vaguely. An actual entity is felt as said to be objectified for that subject. Only a selection of eternal objects are felt by a given subject, and these eternal objects are then said to have ingression in that subject. But those eternal objects which are not felt are not therefore negligible. For each negative prehension has its own subjective form, however trivial and faint. It adds to the emotional complex, though not to the objective data. The emotional complex is the subjective form of the final satisfaction. The importance of negative prehension arises from the fact that I actual entities form a system, in the sense of entering into each other's constitution, being that by the ontological principle every entity is felt by some actual entity, being that, as a consequence of I and E, every entity in the actual world of a contrascent actuality has some gradation of real relevance to that compression, i.e. that, in consequence of E, the negative prehension of an entity is a fourth step. Space, time and deity, passum. Five, meditation 2, how Haldane and Ross translation. 6 for the analog to this sentence D. Meditation B. Substitute. N 3. Tendons 4. N Cogitant. 42. Discussions and applications. Positive fact with its emotional subjective can. TP, there is a mutual sensitivity of the subjective John's apprehension, so that they are not until the different to each other. Deep the compressance issues in one concrete field till the aim, the satisfaction. Section 2. 67 that we fail to find and experience any element intrinsically in cap a tilde VLE of exhibition as examples of general spirit is the hope of rationalism. This is not a metaphysical premise. It is the case which forms the motive for the pursuit of all sciences alike, including metaphysics. In quick minds, metaphysics enables us to apprehend the rationality of things, the claim is justified. It is always open to us, having regard to the imperfections of all metaphysical systems, to lose hope of the exact point where we find ourselves. The preservation of such faith must depend on an ultimate moral intuition into the nature of intellectual action that it should embody the adventure of hope. Such an intuition marks the point where metaphysics and indeed every science gains assurance from really tilde eon and passes over into religion. Within itself the faith does not embody a premise from which the theory starts. It is an ideal which is seeking status tilde faction. Insofar as we believe the doctrine, we are rationalists. There must, however, be limits to the claim that all the elements in the universe are explicable by theory. First, theory itself requires that there be, given, elements serves to form the material for theorizing. Plato himself recognizes this limitation. I quote from Professor A. E. Taylor's summary of the Timaeus. In the real world there is always, over and above, law, a factor of the, simply given, or, root fact, not accounted for into the AC tilde septum simply is given. It is the business of science never to acquiesce in the merely given, to seek to, explain, it is the consequence, in virtue of rational law, of some simpler initial given. However far psi tilde ends may carry this procedure, it is always forced to retain tilde mend of root fact, the merely given, in its account of things. It is the presence in nature of this element of the given, this third or irrational as it has 68, sometimes been called, which Timaeus appears to be for tilde sonifying in his language about necessity point. So far as the interpretation of Plato is concerned, I rely upon the occult authority of Professor Taylor. But, apart from this historical question, a clear understanding of the given elements in the world is essential for any form of Platonic realism. For rationalistic thought, the notion of givenness carries with it a reference beyond the mere data in question. Occasion is, not. 7 Plato, The Man and His Work, Lincoln Mack V, New York, 1927. Asterisk. Back in form. 43. Given. This element of givenness in things implies some activity procuring limitation. The word decision does not here imply conscious judgment, though in some decision, consciousness will be a factor. The not involve a necessary reference. The only definite actual entity of the temporal world is called a characteristic. In this definition, the conceptual recognition must of course be an operation constituting the will of human belonging to some actual entity. The point of looking at the actual subject is of merely conceiving the eternal object is not thereby in direct relationship to some other actual entity, apart from any other peculiarity in the composition of that conceiving subject. This doctrine applies also to the deprimordial nature of God, which is the conceived entity of an eternal object that is not thereby directly related to the given course of history. The given course of history presupposes this primordial nature, but this primordial nature does not presuppose it. An eternal object is always a potentiality for actual entities, but in itself, as conceptual itself, it is neutral as to the fact of its physical expression in any particular actual entity of the temporal world. Potentiality, which is the relative of givenness. The meaning of givenness is that what is given might not have been given, and that what is not given might have been given. Further, in the complete particular, givenness for an actual entity there is an element of exclusiveness. R71's various primary data, concepts, and fields do not form a mere multiplicity. Their synthesis in the final unity of one actual entity is another fact of givenness. The actual entity terminates its becoming in one complex feeling involving a completely determinate bond with every item in the universe, the bond being either a positive or a negative prehension. This termination is the satisfaction of the actual entity. Thus the addition of another component alters their synthetic givenness. Any additional component is therefore contrary to this integral givenness of the original. This principle may be illustrated by our visual perception of a picture. The pattern of colors is given for us. Fact and form, 45. But an extra patch of red does not constitute a mere addition, it alters the whole balance. Thus in an actual entity the balanced unity of the total, givenness, includes anything that is not given. This is the doctrine of the emergent unity of the superject. An actual entity is to be conceived both as a subject presiding over its own immediacy of becoming, and a superject which is the atomic creature exercising its function of objective immortality. It has become us, and it belongs to the nature of every being, that it is a potential for every becoming. This doctrine, that the final satisfaction of an actual entity is intolerant of any addition, expresses the fact that every actual entity sends it as what it is of creation of a natural entity is a process of transition from indetermination towards terminal determination. The indetermination is referent to determinate data. The objective constitution of a natural entity is its terminal determination, considered as a complex of component determinants by reason of which the actual entity is a datum core. The created advance, L11E actual entity on its physical side is composed of its determinate feelings of its actual world, and on its mental side is originated by its conceptual application. Returning to the correlation of humanness and potentiality, we see that humanness refers to potentiality, and potentiality, so, humanness, also we see that the completion of humanness, the actual fact converts to not human, for that fact and the impossibility, for that fact. The individuality of a natural entity involves an exclusive limitation. This element of exclusive limitation is the definiteness essential to the synthetic unity of a natural entity. This synthetic unity forges the notion of mere addition to the included element. It is evident that givenness and potentiality are both meaningless apart from a multiplicity of potential entities. Potentiality is an eternal object. Apart from potentiality and givenness, there can be no. 46. Discussions and applications. Nexus of actual things and processes to possession by